everyone, it's Sevy. You mostly know me for being calm and collected in my review videos, but today, I am furious. Today, I am a confused and angry Sevy. From my title and thumbnail, you will likely be able to guess why. I want to talk to you all about how the Everlasting Moonglow could be one of the worst 5-star weapons, if not the worst weapon in the game. Now, don't be mistaken, I'm still completely objective in this review. I have good evidence as to why this weapon is so bad, testing evidence, not just theoretical evidence. But here's your fair warning that I'm going to be a bit more unhinged this time. Before everything else, I'll just remind you to play for your joy. If you're already using Moonglow or want an aesthetically complete Kokomi, then go for it. I don't want anyone to bash others for using Moonglow because we don't do that here. But if you're looking for a comparison to determine whether or not to pull for Moonglow, you have got one coming. So I have Kokomi's signature catalyst on her primarily for the content and drip. Even before it was released, I've already been lurking on Kokomi main threads and seeing conclusions that this weapon is only slightly better than the prototype Amber. I had already set my expectations quite low to shield myself from disappointment. But boy oh boy, was I not prepared for this. For this review and comparison of the Everlasting Moonglow, I'm going to directly compare it to the closest free-to-play equivalent, which is the prototype Amber. Previously, it was only ever really viable on Barbara, but now it's found another use in Kokomi. For a bonus, I'll compare the damage of Thrilling Tales as well. The Thrilling Tales is a very different weapon with an entirely different purpose, but for the sake of comparison, I'll include it quickly. If you're looking for a more comprehensive weapons comparison, that might be for another time. For now, we're focusing on these weapons only. Let's dive in. First of all, it's obvious that the Everlasting Moonglow will output more damage than the prototype Amber. It has a higher base attack and HP percent stat. It adds to her healing bonus, which her damage can scale on, and it gives additional HP scaling for her attack damage. But reading it carefully, there's already one red flag spotted. That HP scaling addition only benefits her normal attack. That's right, her normal attack only. This is a bit perplexing since Kokomi's best damage multiplier is with her charged attack. Also, I think one of her best attack rotations is 2 normal attacks then 1 charged attack. So I really don't see any reason why this has to be locked behind only her normal attack. It boggles the mind. Let's see the damage in action during her burst. I will show the prototype Amber first, then the Everlasting Moonglow. Here are the consolidated damage numbers. Let's include the Thrilling Tales number data for comparison. As you can see, Moonglow gave around a 20% damage increase on her normal attack compared to prototype Amber, and the prototype Amber damage is not far from the Thrilling Tales. But for her charged attack, Moonglow's increase is only around 12% versus prototype Amber. Your results may vary depending on the stats you have for your Kokomi, but this is what I got. Note that this is without vape reactions, but even on a vape, that proportion is still similar. So when it comes to damage, this is a very marginal upgrade. 20% increase sounds significant in theory, but Kokomi's attack damage is already low in the first place, and I believe dealing damage isn't her main purpose anyway. From my first impressions video, I highly think Kokomi works well as a support and enabler, and she can support and enable in other ways. Namely, if the Moonglow actually helped her energy. Now this is what gets me. The energy restoration is actually a downgrade compared to prototype Amber. Now reading the description again, we see the same red flag appear. Kokomi's energy only gets restored when she hits opponents with her normal attack. Only with her normal attack. Again, not charged attacks. At this point, I am pulling my hair out of confusion. So here are the test clips. Let's focus on how many normal attacks I can get in and the energy restored. I tried it on 2 attack rotations. First is doing 3 normal attacks jump cancel rotation. Let me break down what happens from the moment her burst begins. We start with her close-up animation. This lasts for 1 second. When you activate the burst, you already see that Kokomi's burst countdown has elapsed that 1 second. Assuming the Moonglow's energy effect follows the same, it also begins its countdown. That's 1 second where you're not attacking, which means that effectively the energy restoration mechanic lasts for 11 seconds only instead of 12. At least that's how I understand it. Now let's see how many hits I can get in with average animation canceling skills. From my count, I was able to get in 18 hits before the duration expired. Note that even when her burst has ended, you still have 1 second left to get some hits in before the weapon's effect expires. 18 hits is equivalent to 10.8 energy restored. Looking at her burst, it seems about right. Now let's try it on a 2 normal attack jump cancel rotation. These numbers are immensely underwhelming compared to the prototype Amber. At R1, prototype Amber restores 4 energy every 2 seconds within 6 seconds. That means it can restore a total of 12 energy, which is already higher than an R1 Moonglow. Who thought of this? Is this real? Then, if you refine prototype Amber to R5, it can regenerate a total of 18 energy, whereas the Moonglow's energy refund does not benefit at all from its refinements, since the refinements don't increase the restored energy. It stays at a constant 0.6. What makes Moonglow worse in terms of energy refunding is that you can still get interrupted. I know that I said Kokomi is fairly resistant to interruption, and I find it easy enough to play her without a shield. But she's not immune to interruption. Getting the most out of Moonglow demands zero interruption. So if you don't put a shield on Kokomi, any interruption is a big loss on the potential energy refund. The only way that Moonglow can beat prototype Amber in terms of energy refund is if you stack attack speed bonuses on Kokomi. This is something she can innately do, but you have to get her at C4, which also adds an energy restoration mechanic. But this is whale territory, and it shouldn't have been an issue in the first place, in my opinion. So, if you thought that Moonglow is one of the solutions to Kokomi's energy problem, it's not. Her C4 is. Or an R5 prototype Amber. So look, there's an upside to this. Non-whales or non-weapon banner pullers are not missing out on anything. Except maybe that Jade Cutter. I really should have set my path to Jade Cutter. If you already have prototype Amber or even refinements, bless you, your Kokomi is happy. Or even Thrilling Tails. She'll be fine. F2Ps and low spenders, you are winning here. So much. It looks damn good. It's a very, very pretty weapon, and it completes Kokomi's drip. I'll give it that. But the rest is up to you, and again, I completely encourage you to play the way you want to, whatever gives you the most fun or joy. So, as always, if this video helped you out, please do leave a like and consider subscribing. It really helps me a lot. Leave a comment below what you thought of this weapon, and look forward to more Kokomi videos, and I will see you soon. Take care!